playoffs are officially here.
Let me be it. I'm from the south, never had a handout
for a limit. Oh boy, here we go. Game 3 of the quarterfinal series between the heavy hitters, East Lake Eagles, Teddy Piper, Jimmy Hambley. The series is tied at 1. It's a winner go home for both these teams. Winner take all. I guess I'll get Carson Kish and Connor Gulterman and Jimmy Hambley. He seems to be walking over here ready to be in an interview anyways, so interview them here before this winner go home game. Carson, first question, who's in the bump for game 3?
It'll be Connor.
What's it going to take here to win this game and take the series from the hitters?
Well, we had a strategy last game, but it didn't really work out. So I think we're going to change it up, really try to hit the ball. I'm not sure who's pitching for them, but it'll probably be someone we haven't seen yet. So I don't know. We just got to hit the ball. We didn't really do that last game.
Jimmy, you struggled a bit at the plate last game. Had one clutch hit there in the fourth, I believe. But outside of that, it was a little bit of a struggle. How are you going to change your approach here in game 3 in a win-or-go-home game?
Just leave everything on the field, you know. Just do that. I can't really talk trash at all because I haven't shown up at all. So, yeah.
All right, Connor Gulterman, you were on the mound in the biggest game of the season for your team. Do you plan to prove yourself here in game 3 and take the series?
We'll have to see right here. I hope so. I mean, I think I have a nice riser, and that's pretty much it, but we'll see.
Is that all you got?
Yeah,
that's all I got. All right, we'll go on to game 3. It's win or go home for the Eagles and the hitters. Well, see y'all in the game.
Connor Gulterman, Pottstown University. Bless.
Carson Kish, Welch Elementary.
Jimmy Hambley, Deez Nuss University.
Gray Will Banks, KSU.
Kateron, I dropped out.
Lefty Hedrick, Biscuit Bashers.
Andrew Tate, I'm going to Duke University.
Teddy Piper, East Quid High School.
Yeah. 5-1 on Gulterman. Pitcher Mia.
Swinging a shot to left field. Teddy misses
it. This is it, dude. Oh,
no, Connor will hold up there with a leadoff single in game 3 for the Eagles. And now the captain, Carson Kish, is up.
This game is really going to be just who wants it more.
Oh, a shot to center. That ball's carrying. It is up against the wall. Dropped by Teddy. He's out at second. A very, very, very long single. Kish a few feet away from a two-run shot. This is my Player of the Week song right here. In there. What a pitch. Strike 3, 2 away. That's a big out for the hitters and Ian. Oh, a shot to left. That ball's carrying. It's gone. A two-run home run for Gray Will Banks, and the Eagles are on the board first. They take a 2-0 lead in game 3, a win-or-go-home game. The Eagles are on the board. A clutch home run for Gray Will Banks. Swing and a miss, and Ian gets out of it. We go bottom one. 2-0 Eagles. They strike first in a winner-go-home game for both teams. Wow. Ball 6. Lead-off walk for the hitters.
hits on ball six. First and second, and no outs for the captain, Teddy Piper. Lopped in there. Grounded on the left side. It is a fair ball. He's out. The runners advance. Second and third and one away for lefty Hedrick. Oh, strike three on a lob. Two away. A hit here would be huge for the hitters. Swing and a shot down. Anxiety's high once again. Full count. Lopped in there. Ball six. Base is loaded and two away for Teddy Piper. 4-0. Oh, grounded up the middle. And Connor gets out of it with no damage. Very stressful ending, but Connor gets out of it. We go top two. 2-0 Eagles in game three of this incredible series. Pitch me in. Ball six. Leadoff walk for Connor Golterman. They got a runner on first and no outs. And now Carson Kish is up for the East Lake Eagles. All right, can do it then. 5-1. Ball six, back-to-back walks to lead off the inning, and Jimmy Hambley's up now. Low, three straight walks. The bases are loaded and no outs.
Hambley.
Ball six, walks in a run. 3-0 Eagles in the top of the second. And the hitters are making the call to the captain, Teddy Piper. They're desperate for some outs. Base is loaded and no outs. Grounded up the middle. One out. Goes home. Double play. Got him. Plays dead. Plays dead. Plays dead.
5-1.
Oh, he hit him. He's out, isn't he? He's out. He's out of home now. He's out of home now. All right, now he's out. We go bottom two. The Eagles extend the lead to 3-0. The hitters are desperate for some runs here in the second inning. Grounded on the right side, and he is out for the first out of the inning. What was the point doing that? Grounded up the middle, and that's two outs. All right, full count on Teddy Piper. Pitch from Goldsman. Ball six. The hitters have a runner with two outs. Game where Tyler beat. Ball six. First and second, two away for Ian McDaniel. A bomb ties it. Oh, drilled in the left field. And Kish bobbles it. He's safe. The bases are loaded now and two away. Lobbed in there. Grounded up the middle, and Connor gets out of it again with no damage. The Eagles are three outs away from winning the series. We go top three. 3-0 East Lake Eagles. Grounded in the left. Ian is up against the fence, and he's going to be safe. He's going to second. Leadoff single and an error on Teddy. Might want to switch it after this frame. Swing and a miss. One away. That's a big out. We're on second and one away. Drilled in the left field. That's going to roll all the way to the fence. Connor's rounding third. He's going to score with a phone in his hand. An RBI double for Jimmy Hambley. 4-0 Eagles at the top of the third. Oh, drilled the center. That ball's carrying at the fifth. It's caught. Jimmy's going to try and tag up. He's rounding third. He is safe at home. Somehow that ends up being a sack fly. And it's outside. It's a walk. We got a run on first and two away for Connor Golterman, I believe. 1-1. Oh, popped up to left. Fair ball, and he's going to be out for the third out of the inning. All right, we go bottom three. 5-0 Eagles. Eagles are three outs away from winning the series and advancing to the semifinals. 1-1. It's a Hedrick is drilled to right, and it is up against the wall. Long single. And it, oh, he's off the back. He's running. He's safe. He's safe. Oh, wow. 1-1. Oh, grounded. It is fair. He's out. One away. Runner gets the third. Oh, ground up the middle. Two away. Safe. Ball gets, that's out of play. Well, just run. Even if it's not out of play, safe at home. So the hitter's gonna run 5-1, two away, and the game is on the line for Henry Hedrick, and they're gonna sub in. You know Galterman can't go back in, right? Oh, popped up to right. Galterman's under it. He dropped it. What just happened? Oh no, he chokes. That would have sent the Eagles to the next round. Lobbed in there. Oh, he grounds it. And it is out. He's out. The Eagles win the game 5-1. And they win the series 2-1. The Eagles started out the season 2-7. But ever since then, they've been 6-3. They win the series 2-1. The heavy hitter season is over. And my bracket's not yet. Eagles win the series 2-1. They will face the Winchester Warriors on Saturday in the semifinals. Hitter season's over. Let's get into the postgame interviews. I'm Elijah Edwards. We just finished up the quarterfinal series between the Eastlake Eagles and the heavy hitters. The Eastlake Eagles grinded out a win, 2-1 series win. Every game was competitive. It was very exciting to watch, but the series is over. They'll play the Winchester Warriors next week in semifinals. Meanwhile, the heavy hitters, their season is over. I'll bring in Teddy Piper and Ian McDaniel as they're the heavy hitters left here today. Talk about their series and the season. All right, I'll get to Ian first. You came in late, second half of the season with this team. But you made a bit of a run, but ultimately a loss in the first round. How do you feel about the season as a whole?
It was good. If I wasn't sleeping, and they won the first game, but if I wasn't sleeping, it would have been a different story, just saying.
Do you think you'll be on this team again next season? And if so, do you think y'all can come back and make a run?
Maybe. I don't know. It's up to Teddy. It's not my decision. I want to. Okay.
Sounds good. I'll get the Teddy Piper here, the captain. All right, Teddy, your team last year was the underdog but ended up making a run for the World Series this year. Same record, was hoping to do the same thing, but he ultimately lost in three games here in the first round to your rival, Jimmy Hambly. What went wrong in the series today, and how do you feel about the season overall?
I just sucked today. That was it. Tired, sore. Yeah, that happened.
How many times did he strike out? How many times did this strike out? Many times. Many times. You have no reason to be talking.
You're trash. You're done for the year. You're terrible.
Did you get one hit your entire
Teddy?
I think he had three home runs.
What?
So I think he had three home runs.
It's only
about nine times today.
It's only three hits or home runs.
Yeah, we still won.
By your teammates.
Yeah, exactly.
By your teammates.
They're down a man, but we still won.
Here we go.
He barely even said anything.
Teddy, what was the question? How do you feel about the series and the season as a whole?
Season was okay, you know. Same record as last year. Didn't improve.
Not exactly. I mean, 7-11. You know, we're 9-12 last year. So. Slightly worse, actually. Just putting it out there.
We didn't make the World Series. But, season was okay. You know, started off 0-3. Then come back, winning the series against the Heat. And then felt confident after that. Then had to play in a freaking rain series, which was god-awful. Against the Commanders. Lost that series. Then...
Do the whole season.
Yeah, the whole season. And what, after that, we played the Eagles, right?
Yeah.
Beat them. Then lost the series against the Bastards, and today just didn't perform well. Tired, but it's all right. We'll see what happens off season. Might retire, might not. Might not be a captain. Might not be a captain. Might want to resign. Who knows? We'll see what happens.
Thank you, Teddy. It was nice having you this season. I'll bring in the whole Eastlake Eagles team now. Discuss their series win and the round ahead of them in a few days.
Get up and get over here.
I'll go to Caden first.
You were a minimal shower for this team in the first half, but showed up a lot in the second half, started hitting the ball, came here today, contributed a little bit to the series win. Y'all won the series. Now you're all in the semifinals. How does it feel?
Good.
So, yeah. All right, Connor. Get you in here. You were the number one overall pick this season. Contributed a lot to the team, but the winning pitcher in game three. Your team started out 2-7, but somehow y'all have scrounged together a lot of wins here recently. Now y'all are in the final four. How does it feel?
It's great. We know the power of the chop really works. Ha! And we all know that this guy did absolutely nothing for all the games. But last series, you also did nothing. But never mind. But I think we're swinging the bats well now. Getting ready to face you, but it'll be a great series. Probably get swept, but I mean, it might go through games.
That's all for Connor. All right, Jimmy, come over here. You were the captain of this team to start the season, but now you've kind of slowly just been demoted to just a player on the team. But regardless, this was your team, and you're still a big part of this team. Y'all won the series. After a very slow start, y'all somehow made your way to the Final Four. How does it feel to win this series against your rival, Teddy, and how does it feel to be in the semifinals?
Grandpa.
What does that mean?
So, I was talking shit in the manager's group chat. Yes, you were.
I was doubting myself. I said we're going to lose in two.
No, but you were also saying that I sucked and the whole team sucked.
Teddy's bipolar. Just forget about it.
No one can hit on our team.
Teddy's just bipolar.
Grandpa.
That's another day.
We're going to sweep the Warriors.
Oh, yeah! All right. I'll get to Carson Kish. You are a second-round pick, slowly have become the captain of this team. As a rookie, you've carried this team to the Final Four. How does it feel after starting out the season 2-7, now being 6-3 in your last 9 games?
Yeah, that's pretty good. We're starting to hit better. We didn't really hit the best today. We're having trouble hitting the ball today. I think we pitched pretty well. The pitching is what won us this series. So I think going into the Warrior series, pitching good, that's good because the Warriors swing more than these other teams that we're playing, so we're barely missing on some pitches, and those will be strikes against the Warriors. So I'm confident. I think we have a good shot, and we got a good amount of momentum going into the next series.
You do. In the last 6 games, the Eagles are 5-1, and after starting out 2-7, their last 9 games are 6-3. So I'm just gonna put that out there. I don't really have any more questions. That's it for the quarterfinal series. We'll see y'all next video. We have semifinal matchup set. Will be the Warriors and the Eagles and the Commanders and the Bashers. And I look forward to it. See y'all then.